Hi, welcome to Lachlan Likes a Thing, a show where I take a thing and see whether or not I like it. Now the thing we're looking at in this video is the Microsoft Surface Pro 2, which is the new version of Microsoft's Windows 8 professional tablet computer. Now I've actually owned the Surface Pro 2 for over a month now, and I'm actually a long-term owner of the original Surface Pro 1. And I've actually already made a comparison video of the Surface Pro 1 with the 11-inch MacBook Air, the Nexus 7 Android tablets, and the Wacom graphics drawing tablets. And since the Surface Pro 2 and the Surface Pro 1 are so similar, I'm gonna try not to repeat myself too much. You can find a link to the comparison video in the description of this video below. But here's a basic summary of my impressions of the Surface Pro 2. The Surface Pro 2 is an incredibly versatile and well-built machine with this really amazing, really nicely crafted magnesium alloy chassis. And the whole design really centers around this kickstand, which lets you angle the screen on a flat surface, and these detachable typing covers, which you actually have to purchase separately. And they just click in like that and the whole machine fits together. Now, as a laptop replacement, the Surface Pro 2 is quite good because it's lightweight, it's quite powerful, and it's still very, very portable. However, there are situations where the Surface Pro 2 is quite difficult to use when you don't have access to a completely flat surface to lay the kickstand and the keyboard on, especially because the keyboard is not a rigid element of the Surface Pro 2's design, and the weight of the Surface Pro is mostly in the screen. Now, this has been improved somewhat with the introduction of the new Type Cover 2 and the new Touch Cover 2, because they're a bit more rigid, and I've got video reviews of the Touch Cover 2 and the Type Cover 2 in the description of this video below, so you can check those out if you like, but it's still not completely perfect. Now, compared to a lot of laptops, the Surface Pro 2 is very slimline and lightweight, but compared to tablet computers like the iPad Air and the Nexus 10 Android tablets, the Surface Pro 2 is really quite thick and really quite heavy. And in general, it's quite bulky and difficult to use casually, just carrying it around in one hand. However, once you set it down with the kickstand and get it comfortable with it, the Surface Pro really starts to shine. And this is especially because the Surface Pro runs a full version of Windows 8 Professional. And that means that it will run anything that will run on a Windows 8 computer. So that includes Microsoft Office, it includes Adobe programs like Photoshop and Illustrator, and the entire library of Steam games will operate on the Surface Pro 2. And with the Surface Pro 2, you get a USB port and a mini display monitor out cable. So, you know, you can hook this up to all kinds of peripherals, all kinds of monitors, and it will work exactly like a full screen laptop. Now, in case you didn't notice from the giant iMac behind me, I am a Mac user and I've been a Mac user for over 6 years. And I have to tell you, coming from a Mac user, I really actually love Windows 8 as a modern touchscreen mobile operating system. And I think it especially works well compared to other tablet operating systems like iOS and Android, just because you can do this amazingly powerful multitasking and have multiple panels open at the same time, and the gesture support and everything is quite versatile and quite powerful. And I love the fact that because it's a full-blown desktop operating system, you get complete access to a file system where you can move files around on a hard drive, and all the other kind of things you get with Windows 8. Now, perhaps that's a bit overkill if all you wanted from a tablet was to be able to browse the internet and launch a few apps. But for my purposes, I really like the fact that the Surface Pro is something that you can get really quite productive with the Windows 8 operating system. And because the Surface Pro 2 runs programs like Photoshop, and it has a really color accurate screen, and it has a pressure sensitive Wacom stylus input, the Surface Pro 2 is a really attractive option to photographers and designers and kind of artists, just because you can kind of design and create content on the fly in a really tiny machine. So that's my summary of the whole Surface Pro concept. The Surface Pro is definitely a machine that's targeted towards power users who want to get some of the benefits that they get from a tablet and some of the benefits of a laptop just in one single package in a really lightweight and quite powerful design. Now I really want to focus on the specific differences between the original Surface Pro and the new Surface Pro 2. Now, the Surface Pro 2 is more or less physically identical to the original Surface Pro 1. But Microsoft made lots of very, very small tweaks and changes to the Surface Pro 1, especially in areas where the Surface Pro 1 was lacking. So kudos to Microsoft for listening to user feedback and improving the Surface Pro 2. The Surface Pro 2 now comes in four different configurations. It comes in 128 and 64 gigabyte solid state storage options with 4 gigabytes of RAM, and 256 and 512 gigabytes of solid state storage with 8 gigabytes of RAM. Now, I got the 256/8 gigabyte option, and there's quite a jump up in price from the 128 gigabyte options. So I got my 256 gigabyte for about $1,300 directly from the Microsoft store, including a 10% student discount. So that's quite a hefty chunk of change. And unless you're thinking of doing photo editing or playing games on the Surface Pro 2, I think you'd find the 128 gigabyte option more than enough for general web browsing tasks, taking notes at university, etc., etc. Now, I could spend ages going through all the incremental improvements they made with the Surface Pro 2. I mean, it runs slightly faster, it runs slightly cooler, the speakers now are a lot louder, and honestly, I could make a really long video, but you'd probably be better off reading a written review with all the kind of little improvements. I just wanted to focus on the three big improvements over the original Surface Pro, which really improved the experience for me. The first one is that the kickstand now comes with a variable angle. So it can come out in this kind of 45 degree angle and the 90 degree angle here. Now, this may not seem like much, it's just pretty much just an extra angle, but if you're a taller user like me, I find that generally the kind of steeper angle of the original kickstand would give me a little discomfort after a while, and the 90 degree angle really, really helps. And the 90 degree angle also means that you can use the Surface Pro in all kinds of situations that you couldn't previously use the original Surface Pro. So it's much easier to use cross-legged, it's much easier to use on your knees now because the center of gravity of the Surface Pro is lower and it doesn't feel like the whole machine's just gonna tip off the front of your knees. If you're an owner of the original Surface Pro, the extra angle on the kickstand is almost enough reason alone to upgrade. The second big change on the Surface Pro 2 is battery life. On the original Surface Pro 1, I'd get about 3.5 to 4 hours of battery life, which is pretty bad for a laptop and downright embarrassing compared to the tablet computers. Now, with the Surface Pro 2, with a lot of little tweaks and the new Intel Haswell processors, I get about 8 to 9 hours of battery life on the Surface Pro 2. And because the whole machine runs more efficiently now, it also runs cooler, which is a lot easier to hold in your hands. So overall, the Surface Pro 2, just in regards to battery life, is a huge improvement. Now, the last big change that I want to mention with the Surface Pro 2 is something that's actually quite exciting to me. And that is, the Surface Pro 2 now comes with Intel HD 4400 graphics, which is quite a step up over the graphics chip found in the original Surface Pro 1. Now, it used to be that the phrase Intel integrated graphics would make me die a little inside, just because of how awful that kind of integrated graphics chips were. But thankfully, with the new Haswell chips, the Intel HD 4400 is quite a decent graphics card. It's certainly no powerhouse. I mean, you still have to run settings in newer games at lower settings, but you know, it's actually not too shabby. With the Surface Pro 2, if you have a wireless mouse and keyboard, and even with the stylus, it works quite well with simulation or strategy games like SimCity or StarCraft 2, or Civilization 5, which has actual touchscreen input options. But the really cool thing I discovered with the Surface Pro 2 recently was that with the USB port, you can just hook up a Xbox 360 controller for $36, and you can use Steam Big Picture and a bunch of other games that support controller input to actually play a bunch of titles with the console controller. And that's really awesome because it turns the Surface Pro 2 into like a little miniature gaming console. Now, for games like Skyrim or any of Valve's titles like Portal or Team Fortress, this works really well. And I found that the Surface Pro 2 works especially well with small kind of indie titles that accept controller input, like Hotline Miami, Gone Home, all those kind of little kind of titles that don't take too much toll on the system resources. But even games like Skyrim look quite nice on the Surface Pro 2 screen because the screen is very pixel dense. It's very detailed, so even if you have to turn down the settings, you don't really notice. And I can tell you, I'm really looking forward to my next plane flight where I can just put this up on the tray table and just game away for a few hours. Now, note, you have to bring along your charger. It really kills the battery life playing games on the Surface Pro 2. You'll get about 2 or 3 hours. But even then, I think it's a really nice add-on to the Surface Pro 2 with the upgraded graphics ability. Now, I'm actually thinking of making a series of small videos just to demonstrate what games work well and what kind of settings you need on the Surface Pro 2. So let me know in the comments if you want to see those kind of videos. So overall, the Surface Pro 2 is pretty uniquely positioned on the marketplace. And depending on which model you choose, it's quite an expensive machine. And it's even more expensive considering that you had to buy the keyboard separately from the Surface Pro. It's even more expensive than the 11-inch MacBook Air. And honestly, for most users, if all you wanted to do was have a new kind of laptop that you could take around university and type notes on, or just browse the web, I think the Surface Pro is maybe a little overkill, and you'd be better off with an Ultrabook or something like the 11-inch MacBook Air. But if you can think of how all the features of the Surface Pro will kind of work in your workflow, so how you can use the stylus and the touchscreen, and just having a computer that also turns into a tablet, if you can think of how that really works well for you, then I think it's worth the investment. Now, personally, I really like the Surface Pro 2. I really like that it's a well-built machine that's incredibly versatile and I can get a lot done with it. But honestly, I do recognize it's not for everyone. It's geared more towards kind of power users. So I would recommend, if you're interested in one of these, just head on over to the store and play around with it, and you might be quite impressed. Anyway, I'm looking forward to your comments. Please like this video if you found it helpful, and you can subscribe to my channel for more reviews. You can also check out the links in the description of this video, especially if you want to check out whether you want to get the Type Cover 2 or the Touch Cover 2. I'm also going to have a review up of the Nexus 5 phone pretty soon. If you want, you can subscribe to my channel and you can look forward to that. Thanks to all my subscribers for liking my videos and leaving their comments. And it's that time of year again, so I hope you have a really happy holidays and enjoy the rest of 2013.